Now, let's take a look at the space style features. First, I'm going to work from the top viewport. And I'm going to open the styles dialog for the space object, doing right click on the space icon. Here we can see the three styles that we have in that document. And the standard one is the one we have used for the spaces in the model. First, we can check the attributes tab, where we can define the graphic attributes of the space, such as the hatch pattern or the text style. Actually here, when this dimension style is set to biparent, it means that it will use the current Rhino annotation style. We can overwrite the features of this text style by selecting other and changing here the height or the font. From the generals tab, we can hide the boundary of the space. And from the levels tab, we can define the information inside the space level. We can also show and hide the border of the level or show the pattern below the level. But let's take a look at the contents. We can see this syntax that is used to link properties of the space inside the level. In this case, the string inside this syntax is referring to the common property. We are also seeing for this style the area and the perimeter. So for example, if I want to change that parameter for the volume, I can type this prefix. And inside this syntax, I need to type the name of that common property. When I click Apply, I will see the changes on those spaces using that style. Let's delete this one, this information by now, and just keep the name and the area. Sometimes you will need to click outside of this dialog in order to validate the changes. Now, since we have different spaces for different activities, I'm going to create new styles for each one of them. For example, I will have a space style for this exterior area, another one for this common area, and another for the wet areas such as toilets or kitchens. So I'm going to do right click here, duplicate this style just a few times. And now I will use this one for the exterior area. Under the attributes tab, I will change the pattern to, for example, plus pattern. I can also change the scale and the angle. This one can be the wet areas. I can keep this double pattern, but I will change the scale and the rotation. Also here, I'm going to assign a specific color, like cyan. And this one would be for the common areas. In this case, I'm going to use a double pattern with a smaller scale and a zero rotation. Actually, I will use the standard name for the rest of the spaces. I will just change the pattern scale to a single 0.2 and keep the angle. Now we can see the changes done on that style, and I'm going to change the style of this space. For example, this one is the exterior style. This other one will take the common areas, and that other one will take the wet areas. Since spaces are located automatically to a specific layer defined in the VisualArQ template, we can assign a color directly to that layer, so all the spaces will take that color. For example, we can assign this gray. All of them except the space style that already took a color by style, such as this one. Now, if we select any of these spaces, for example this one, and we check under the Properties panel the custom parameters, we can see that we've got this list of parameters defined in the VisualArQ template and the information that this space can store. For example, we can assign here a value for the finish parameter, such as sand. If we want to display this detail, this parameter, into the level, we need to use the following formula. So let's open the styles dialog of the space. I will select this style, exterior one, and from the levels tab, we'll need to type the following formula. So I'm going to copy this syntax. And now, instead of this common property name, we'll type parameters, insert these brackets, and inside it, type the name of the parameter, which is finish. You can also add here a prefix. I click OK, and now we can see that custom parameter displayed inside this level. Of course, if we select the space and change this value into a gravel, for example, I will need to select the space, go to VisualArQ Tools, toolbar, and run the update command to see the changes. If you don't want to remember the name of this syntax used to display custom parameters, you can always check it out in the VisualArQ help that we can find on VisualArQ menu, help, view help, and here under documentation tools, space, space styles, we scroll down, and we will see here the syntax used for listing common properties and custom parameters and also style parameters.